Hey everybody, what's up? This guy's excited. I'm excited too. Battlefield 3 online gameplay coming at you here. Doing Tehran Highway, which I'm not going to lie is probably the map I'm the worst at. But it's alright, maybe this will turn out to be okay because I'm sitting here just chilling in the APC. Just hanging out here. I mean, it's got six seats, so you got somebody at each window too. You got the gunner and the driver. I came in last, so I've probably got the worst seat here you can have. Works out though, because when you go to one of the flags, a lot easier to be able to take it when you got more people there. So, oh, you can shoot out here too. I usually don't ride in this thing, but anyway, I might just keep that in mind here. Now, I think I'm going to do some more Rush videos and stuff like that, because I don't think I've posted any Rush videos yet. I think it's been all Conquest, but honestly, Conquest is my favorite. I don't know why. I would like to do some squad matches too, like squad team deathmatch, squad rush. That would be a lot of fun. Oh, there's someone. Yes, I could probably kill him from here, but I'm totally getting shot at by the tank. Anyway, so I guess it's kind of call out to everybody here. Who wants to start up a squad, I guess I should say, because you guys know my schedule's not the greatest. I work late at night. However, you know, Sundays and Mondays, yeah, you know, those are my days off, so maybe we could do something then. But I really don't know how many people who watch the channel play Battlefield 3. I think it'd be kind of cool to kind of put something together. But everybody having their own role, stuff like that. I would like to play the role of engineer, since that's the one that I seem to do the most and to rock the most at here. But I don't know. I think it'd be fun to just try. I mean, it's not something permanent by any means. But, ooh, sweet. Sweet. Totally not leading him enough. That was weak. And dying too, by the way, guys, is also weak. But I need you guys' help with something. Because with me making partner with Machinima and also with YouTube here, my channel, I don't want this to come off like I think it's bad or anything, but I think that the way that it looks could be improved. So that being the case here, sweet, this is going to be easy. Nope, maybe not. All right, last bullet kills him. I just wanted to look more professional here. With that being the case here, I don't think that the background that I have right now of all the sports stuff and everything really looks too professional. I mean, you look at some of the other commentators that are out there, theirs looks a lot better than mine. And so I've tried dabbing around at a background or a logo or something like that. Haven't done too great. I'm at 6%, so I'm going to hide here and wait to heal. So I've kind of reached out to some people who do backgrounds for YouTube. Everybody's been like, yeah, sure, I'll do it for you, but I'm backed up, so it may take a few months, which, I mean, I want it to look as good as it can, as soon as it can. Now, I've always been surprised with the viewers and what you guys have, or what the connections that you have with other people, because, I mean, it's just phenomenal. It seems like I know somebody who knows somebody else who's really big, you know, stuff like that. So I was just curious if you guys knew anybody who would make a background for me, preferably free. Because who likes spending money, right? I mean, I like getting stuff, I just don't like spending money. So, if you guys know anybody, let them send me a message, or send me a message, you can, and let me know who they are, and maybe I'll try and get in contact with them. Because, I mean, I do want to make some changes. I mean, I don't think that there's anything necessarily wrong with this channel right now, but if you always take the perspective, there's always area for improvement. You're going to find something, and you're always going to make something better, too. So that's kind of the approach that I'm taking with this here. I just want this all to look better. Oh, my gosh. There's a Hummer. All right. I got the hit, so let's see what happens from it. I probably should have gone with another rocket. Shot from behind like a real man. But anyway. So, yeah, I mean, I would like to see the channel look a little bit different. So I guess that was really my call to help in this one. Now, you can see my team's really not doing too great. So let's, should I ride in the tank? Yeah, let's do it. Riding in tanks are fun. I like the vehicles here in this game. I think it's something that adds an interesting element to it, but is not so overwhelming that vehicles control everything. You know, I played some games in the past where it seems like when somebody gets a vehicle, then it's all over with, like it's done. You know, you get one vehicle in one position, and once that vehicle is there, There's really nothing that you can do. Oh, wait. I'm not in a tank. I'm in the APC. My bad. Gosh, some of my military friends are going to kill me for saying that. But I think it's pretty well balanced. I mean, there's enough people that are out there who can stop tanks. At the same time, though, you can, you know, really influence the battle at the same time. So it's a good balance. I really do like it. Kind of wish that not so many people here were at sea, but able to get the flag. Let's see how long I can keep it, though, because there are a lot of people around here. So I'm glad, though, that we've got this, because I don't think I could take out all these guys by myself. Jeez, did I get him? Wish I had thermal. Apparently I didn't get him, but good eye to be able to see those mines. Jeez. That saved us. Anyway, so I'm going to be coming up with some jet gameplay here pretty soon, because I had somebody request that I do some jet gameplay. Because I like rolling with the jets. I don't know about you guys, but like when you get to the map that has the jets, I am so sitting there waiting for one to pop up. And I think I've gotten pretty good at it. I mean, I've had some people send me messages on Facebook who are absolutely pissed off after flying against me and like my squad mate or whoever is flying alongside me. Because a lot of times I'll communicate with the guy, you know, we'll kind of figure out a strategy and we'll go with that. And I don't want to go too much into that, because if I'm doing a jet gameplay video, I don't want to spoil the surprise. You guys know what I mean? Gosh, they took C again. These guys are good, I'm not going to lie. Team's not doing too great in this one here. I think I'm not doing too bad, but at the same time, jeez. So at least we got A, but the thing is A is on the other side of the map. And when you got what's on the other side of the map, you know that that's what they're probably going to be going to the most. Because, like, first one you get is the one closest to you. And that's the one I feel like I've got to defend the most, is the one closest to us. Because if you can really get backed up, you know, and they have all the positions. I mean, you go from your initial spawn point in the map. And if you do that, there's a pretty good chance you guys can get pinned down and this one's over with. So I always feel like I got a defense lead. Luckily, the guy driving with me here feels the same way too. So we're rocking this one here. Kind of wishing we'd get this guy. This guy's tough. All right, so he got him. Anyway, so you can see A's already fallen. C and B, this is something we'd want to hold here at this point. But I don't know how these guys are getting over to the other side of the map grabbing C, because somebody is taking that right now. And when I was doing this, I didn't even notice this. Apparently the driver didn't either, because this is about ready to turn. So I think it was somebody, though, like spawning with the squad, which is awesome. Because if you can do that just right, where you squat, I almost put those two words together, where you spawn with your squad, you're going to be the major perk, or it can really, really hurt you. If the other team's doing it really well. Because, like, you know, I'll look at a kill cam or something like that, and then we'll just wait. And there'll be one person left, like, going after a flag. And then boom, 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 three other guys spawn right after him. And now you got four people at the flag. And that was just so tough to defend. But, hey, it's part of the game. It's totally all right. And sometimes it can work well for you. So I'm getting out of this guy here. Maybe I can repair it real quick for him. Get the EOD bot out, which I freaking love this thing. But apparently, it's all right. I didn't get it. I need to do one of my EOD gameplay videos. That one was, got a couple of them that are pretty awesome. Like, there's one, I racked up so many points just doing the EOD. Like, it was, I can't remember the name of the map. Oh my gosh. But it's the one where you got two tunnels, and most of the fighting is done in the tunnels. Well, anyway, I get my EOD out, and I just follow the tank the entire time on my team. And he's just freaking destroying people because, well, he's got somebody repairing him all the time. Racked up so many repair medals and all these points off of it. And I got to go back. I got to try and defend C here. So, got him on the run. I think that was kind of making up for the one I had earlier. That was bad. Anyway, all right. So, we're already past our tickets. Man. So, this sucks, because like I don't want to take C, because I have a feeling there's a lot of guys over there, but at the same time, maybe I can prevent some guys from coming over. I don't think they're necessarily taking this route, but anyway, I wish I had the EOD right now. Go out and scout. That's another thing it's useful for too. So if you're like an engineer, I will always roll with EOD. I mean, some people don't necessarily go with it, They'll just go with the torch. But I think EOD is smart because you can repair from a distance, follow the guys, and you can also scout. You can also kill with the thing, too. I mean, you can sneak up behind a guy, just zap him. Wow, that sounded really bad. But anyway, not even going to clarify. I think you guys already picked up on that. But anyway, EOD is pretty sweet. I like it. I'm going to try to see what I can do to help hold B over here. I'm usually pretty careful when I get over here because there's a lot of places to hide that the other team can use to be able to get it. So I'm just going to lay here. I probably shouldn't be moving because, like, the thing is, obviously you can tell this is at night and a lot more people can see when you move than if you just sit still. And I need to move. I need to get out of here. But I need to get up the stairs. Jeez, that was weak sauce. Anyway, okay, other thing I was going to talk about here. I totally almost forgot. I'm going to start coming up with my own phrase. I think that'd be kind of cool. Because we just watched Back to the Future. And Back to the Future 2. And so they go forward in time, 2015, and everybody's calling people bojos. So I figured, hey, I'm going to start calling people bojos. So you'll see how's a bojo move or something like that. I don't know. I'm trying to think about how I want to do this. But anyway, you would think three shots to the back would blow it up. Apparently not. That's all right. I'll just leave it be. There we go. Somebody was still in there after being shot three times by the RPG. Weak sauce. Anyway. Oh, that's a bojo move. There we go. I'm going to start using that. But I don't know how I'm going to use it, though, because bojo move sounds too much like smooth move, which I don't want to do. I don't want to copy anybody else. I want this to be me and me alone. But anyway, team is turning it around. Look at that. I mean, we were down tickets 2-1, and now, shoot, we're only down 30. We hold B and C. Combat efficiency. I'm liking where this is going. Double kill. I'm all right with that. Let's just sit here hiding in the bushes. Guy shooting the freaking laser in my face. Anyway, whew, this is getting kind of intense. Hiding in the bushes. About time someone found me. I can't remember if, like, when you throw a grenade, that's when you pop up on the map or anything like that. But at the same time, that guy has the infrared lens, so he would have been able to spot me, no problem. I need to get that. I really do, because I've used it in one of the games here that I've done. I'm going to just mix it up. Let's try to snipe. I don't think I've posted me sniping at all. At the same time, really isn't too many chances to do it here. But this might be kind of fun here. We'll see. A lot of people staying up on the rooftops. There you go. But it's tough to hit people from that distance, especially when you figure the bullet drops. Maybe I'm aiming too high. I don't know what I'm doing, but gosh, that was weak. Totally deserved that one. It was a Hummer, too. Or a Humvee. Sorry. On fire, so my guys are defending there. Gosh, so they're coming back. They're trying to get to C. If they get C, I think this one's over with, because we've got this one almost tied at this point. This has been a huge comeback. Maybe I'll try to go with the sniper again. Who knows? Maybe my luck will change. I gotta try to get some guy over there, but oh man, I don't know. Sniping's really not my thing. I've never been a great sniper in any game. But at the same time, you gotta learn by doing, right? We probably have a couple kills here by now had I been smart. That's such a distance to have to shoot, though. My gosh. And somebody's shooting at me. Probably can see the... That's what I like, too, like, in the game. Like, if you got a sniper shooting right at you, you can see the light. Or you can see the reflection off of their lens so you can know where they are. So that way you don't have people cheating all the time. You don't have people always going and sniping the entire game. Because that's the one thing I think that's ruined some games, is people just sniping all the time. Anyway. Yep. That was a pretty sweet shot from that guy to be able to get me. So, right on. Alright, do I still snipe? Do I? No. Nope, I'm going to defend the truck here on this one because I gotta hold him. We have the lead now. Huge turnaround. Weak place to spawn. Am I going to live? Am I going to live? Somebody's got the medic kit out. That's what I like about Assault. You get the medic kit, that helps you out so much, but at the same time, I feel like I've got to defend against vehicles, which is why I go with Engineer class, because I think if you can play it smart, you win. So here we go with the EOD. Dang it. Blew that up before I could go there and fix it. So at least I'm going to go over here. I'm going to scout what's out and about. I don't know. Maybe I'll take it back. I didn't really see anything, so it might be kind of safe. Nobody's sitting there. I'm just chilling. There's a vehicle, I think, over here. Let's see what we can do. Looks like my guys are might be taking A. So we'll see what's going on. Some dude over here just chilling with the bazooka. Or the RPG. Gosh, I gotta stop saying that. Anyway, somebody found me. They're shooting at me. I'm just gonna make a run for it. Of course, I'm not gonna make it. That thing's so easy to hit. Can't really move around with it. But anyway. So, alright. So this game is starting to wind down. Look at that. Now we're up 2-1 by way of tickets. Got CMB down. I'm down. Gosh, that guy is... What is that? Twice? Okay. I was afraid. I was like 3 or 4. But I don't know. Game's winding down here. So surprised we came around on this one here. That's strategy. I mean, like I was saying, I mean, if you can at least hold down C. But I don't know. Oh, shoot. I thought they were going after both B and C because I saw them flashing. There's a vehicle down there. What do I do? Because I feel like it's my responsibility to go after it. I don't know why. I think it's because I'm an engineer. But I seriously feel like whenever I see a tank, it's my responsibility to take that thing out here. So I'm just going to chill. I'm going to hang out. I'm going to see what I can do. Because I think that guy's too far away. Sweet hit from the distance. Alright, so he knows I'm here now. Probably not too smart. Because now he's going to be looking for me. 17 tickets left here. So this is probably going to be the last cool thing I can do. So I got to make it big. Try to see what I can do with the EOD. See if we can send him after it. Where is it, though? Stuck in this rubble. Where's that tank? Oh, I think there he was. Man, he's too far away. 11 tickets now. 10. Man, this is going to be over pretty soon. Wait, is it still there? It is still there. All right, so I'm going to sneak up behind it here. Nobody sees the EOD coming. And vehicle destroy assist. That's the thing I love. I mean, granted, only 23% of it was due to me, but geez, the things you can do with the EOD, absolutely awesome. Game changer. Scouts, killers, take out tanks, repair yours. Awesome. But anyway, we end up winning this one. Huge comeback. I mean, we were down by almost 100 at one point. So for us to come back and win, that's awesome. Didn't do too hot, 12-7, but geez, I end up third on the team. So I'm okay with that. I'll take it. Thanks for watching, guys. I definitely appreciate it. You guys are awesome. Like I said, if you guys hear anything about somebody who'll do a background, that would be awesome. Just feel free to let me know. Or if you're interested in doing a squad, let me know. Don't be a bojo. There we go. That's a good use for it. Anyway, I'm going to leave it at that. Thanks for watching, guys.